this is my day. I'm gonna do things my way. This is my day. I'm gonna do things my way. If you believe it,
say it.
Say it. You're gonna make it.
Say it.
Say it. If you believe it,
say it.
Say it.
Yeah.
This is my day.
Welcome to it. This is Trending SA. It's the end of another phenomenal week. And to wrap things up, we are going to bring out all of the things that have been trending on social media platforms. Okay, I am Babi Moloi and I roam these streets with Shaka Sisulu.
TGIF to you at home.
And you have a fan today. Did you bring it?
This one. The one. Singular. Woo.
Did you pay her? Nah. I appreciate that.
Thank you.
You're okay. So loyal. And I prowl these streets with Gooley Roberts.
Oh, wow. Yes.
I hear fire. Lit.
Leave my purse.
And I stalk these streets with Nina Hasty.
My mom and my sister tell me, they're like, Lovey, you do know that you don't look like this all the time. I think I look like this.
But there are lots of people who do that.
Your mom is really cool, because what did she say, like, yesterday's show?
Am I allowed to say this on air?
Yeah, she said...
She goes, Lovey, you know that show is so tit. It's such a tit show.
We love it, eh? Chops.
Chana.
They're fine at home.
They're tit.
Watching the rugby.
Brisky.
Shaka's fan, are you out there? So let's get straight into our first trending hashtag for the day. Shaka Sisulu, what you got for us?
I want to talk about the Olympics. Right, it's a big thing. It's been trending for the past week. We haven't had a chance to speak about it. I know because we have been here all week doing the show. And then when we get home, we switch on our decoders and our catch-up and we...
Privilege!
Watch this show. All right, and so we have missed quite a bit. I don't want to talk about all the stuff that we have missed, particularly... the amount of medals that we've gotten this year, and I want to kind of see if we're on track to beat our last Olympic performance or not.
Can I tell you, I am obsessed with the Olympics. Like, I love...
It's your vibe.
I just think it's so fun. You never get to see these things. So the other day we watched fencing, and we were like, yo. And then we watched judo, female judo. And then did you see...
Do you know I was watching a woman's... weightlifting.
Don't say weightlifting.
I swear!
I was watching women's weightlifting.
Did you see the together? Anyway, did you see those women?
But did you see that Brazilian woman?
Did you see the Thai woman?
Nina, what are you talking about?
I am talking about social media celebrities. You know, that's my vibes. And it is a Friday, so of course we're bringing in one of my friends!
We're bringing friends.
So ratchet out of the blue.
And there's nothing better than a good laugh on a Friday to gear us up on the weekend. So we'll be having an award-winning comedian, Tumi Stop-Nonsense. Stop-Nonsense. That's, don't ever do that accent. Coolie, I see you. And social media alter ego known as Jumaima. Now, if you haven't seen his videos on YouTube, you've been missing out. And some hilarious clips. Okay, so we'll get to know both Tumi and Jumaima, both sides, the AKAs, and a little bit better today. So that's what I have planned for you.
Beautiful.
And what you have is more nepotism, cronyism. Your friends again.
Yes, I'm nepotizing. I'm nepotizing, comrade.
As long as they're local.
Yeah, they're local and lacquer.
Goodie, what you
right.
Got
right, unfortunately, I'm going to be a bit sad. I'm talking about my hashtag is hashtag Fat Side Stories. You know, like West Side Stories.
Yeah.
This hashtag caught my eye this week. And learning the root of it made me really, really sick. Because I realized how shallow people are on social media. A quick backstory. This is what happened. A Mexican gymnast was body shamed on social media this week while participating in the 2016 Olympics in Rio. This girl has been doing very, very well the sport, but this has not changed the people from Mexico. It hasn't overshadowed. It has not changed the fact that they're still saying that she's big. They're saying that she's fat. They're body shaming her. So today I want to celebrate this thick girl and other thick girls. So if you're a thick girl out there, send us your picture, you know, tag us, and we'll celebrate you. Because, I mean, come on now. You're beautiful, no matter what size you are.
Exactly. Public body shaming. Something I've never had any experience with or never seen in my life.
Well, I mean, I see it quite frequently on this show.
I'm sorry, Shaga.
Maybe we need to bury the hatchet today. Maybe have
we're
a
gonna,
bit of a moment.
Are we going to bury the hatchet?
No, there's no point because you're going to do it again on Monday.
Then I'm going to be talking about Fashion Week, all right?
So yay!
It's all about AFI Fashion Week, which has been trending on my timeline.
What does AFI stand for?
Oh, Africa?
African
Fashion Industries.
Involvement.
Interesting. So I'm going to Google that during the break and then let you know afterwards. Thanks for throwing me under the bus,
so
Nina.
Sorry,
we'll see you later.
I'm the bus driver.
I'm so sorry. I don't know what AFI is.
This is my day. This is my day.
Welcome back. This is Trending SA. So we all Googled this together. Don't shade me, please. African Fashion International. That's what it means, Nina. Fashion Week. That's what we'll talk about a little bit later on. All right, but now one of Nina's friends has joined us in studio, Dumelo Madila. Welcome. Hello, hello.
Hi, Pabi. How are you?
I'm very well, but you are not just Dumelo. You are... To me, stop nonsense. Yeah. You are also Jumaima.
Mm-hmm.
Nina, tell us more.
That's what Jemima thinks.
The first time I saw you was how many years ago at a comedy competition?
It was, I think, 2 years ago.
2 years ago?
Yes.
And then 5 minutes later, you are a superstar.
I'm already. Like, but why don't you tell them the real story? Because, like, you see, Nina had an... Okay, let me not even say it. But okay. She has something with Joe Nina. So that's where the Nina comes from. And then, like, I was that guy that, like, that brought them, like, together. So that's when we get to, like, you, yeah, that's that guy.
So if I married Joe Nina, I'd be Nina Nina. Is that what you're telling me?
No, I was just telling the people.
What,
like,
Nina?
Tina. Not.
Hey.
Yeah, yes. But that's
it. Yeah, I love the hairstyle. What inspired it?
What just happened?
It's fabulous.
Yeah, no, but honestly, I'm going to...
But you like, you, what inspired the hairstyle? How did you choose
it? I saw it from Wiz Khalifa, like, nice. Doing this, and that was cool for
you
me.
Look,
and I was like, you know,
Khalifa,
thank actually. You very much.
I was about to say.
Yeah.
I thought that you were walking through the kitchen and then somebody dropped some bleach, and then you were just like, oh, well.
Oh, because you stay in a commune.
Why are we shading Tumi? Okay, so Tumi, I saw
you. I'm really friends, though.
Coolie. No shots fired. Get it? Coolie.
China.
Shots fired.
No.
Okay.
Coolie China.
No.
This guy.
Coolie China shots fired.
See, here's the deal. This has become a huge YouTube sensation, right? It's 73,000 views. Can we watch one of your videos?
Yeah, please do.
No, okay, no. So we're gonna go into.
I wanna watch the video, the one where he's with
Go for it.
Let's
watch that. So Patrice Atli Lega Friday, 1991. I feel like Goteng, Ato Challenge. And then I grab my maga akoroba, Atli na mole. And then Patrice Atla Goyena Motor, or Atagamko, Atsuram Mopo, Olegatin, Rodamko, Atsuram Mopo, Mamaga. We're already like I believe my kuto a man, and then they come to us some polish. We no picture of my mother. I'm not has a body lotion and more milling. So I think you can to hear attract Patricia all go in. And then the little girl that believe alo, but fellas have a good relationship. My mama aba pregnant again. And then I write what happened after more because. Patrice will change her number, I change her email address, I change her everything. So since Arena le Patrice ba kopane ko KFC ya go.
You're a funny guy. Is this so kind? Did you ever find each other?
No, guys, like, I don't even like talking about this because people don't understand how difficult it is growing up as Patrice Motsepe's son. Do you know the pressure, Nina? Of being given 7,000 to go to school every day.
Yeah, I'm white, honey.
Every day.
There she burst my bubble. Thank you, Nina.
Fabulous.
Listen, what did your real father say when he sees? Has he seen this video?
Petrus, yeah, no, he saw it.
That's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
Ha, Papa.
Yeah.
More videos?
More videos, please. You are so funny. I just want to ask. So what? So you're not. I mean, you play a female character. And what made you play a female character? Were there things that you felt that you couldn't express as a man, or were you just? What did somebody see you impersonating a woman and go, you know what? You should really do that. Where did this come from?
The whole Jemima character. Honestly, it started back in high school because. I've always wanted to challenge myself, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to theater productions and everything. So I've always wanted to escape the male character and wanted to do something that would give people that impression to know this guy can actually escape who he really is, you know what I'm saying? So when I started comedy, then I remember that I had that ability, you know what I'm saying? And actually, Jemima can actually say things comfortably without any fear or favor because I have two opinions in my head, you know, as a male, and I can also escape to that alter ego as Jemima.
Okay, so let's have a look at one of your Jemima videos.
Joanna Man.
Good day, Zanzi. It's your girl, Julia, aka Jumama. Your number one gossip diva. You better tell somebody that your girl is in the building. Ladies and gentlemen, spring is here, and I figured it's only right if we talk fashion. So today I'm going to be giving you a breakdown of your do's and don'ts of your 2015 spring season. Now, ladies, number one, color blocking for ladies, like, it's a no-no in 2015. Unless you're from Limpopo, then it's acceptable. But guys don't want to be walking around a beach looking at girls and they are looking like amaskopas. It's a no-no. Number two, makeup. Don't get me wrong, ladies. It's okay to wear makeup. It only becomes a problem when you overdo it. 1 minute your girl looks like Alicia Keys, the next minute you find out Michael Jackson. Like, no, it's supposed to be makeup, not plastic surgery. And you know what's the most irritating thing about you overdose your makeup? It's that you can't go around giving hugs because ungcolisa amakhola wabanye abantwana. So.
True,
and joining us now
is
Jumaima, the number one gossip diva.
Hi guys, how are you?
Fabulous.
Okay, who was sitting here?
It's good to meet you guys.
Smells like money. I bet someone was here, was very rich.
Nice. What, like rands or quachas?
I wouldn't know. How would I know? How would
I even
know?
Do you know what a quacha is?
So tell me about Jumaima. Who inspires her?
Okay, Jumaima is the number one gossip diva, that number one girl that's just there on your social media, that's there addressing issues, giving fashion tips, you know, without fear or favor, you know. But you need to also compliment my weave, you know.
We need
Kuli,
to.
Coolie, take notes.
No, we need to. No, we need to. We won't, but we need to.
Are you? Did you get that in my rubber stud?
That's what happens when you're just coolie. I have my dragons. What can we cash you if we wanted to see you performing?
This. I'm actually doing a very big show. I'm filling up the Big Top Arena. Okay. That venue that a lot of shows fail to fill up. I'm actually doing that in 2 weeks' time, 26th of August. I'll be at the Big Top Arena. I have just came up with a good concept called PE Comedy Show, which is the Blessers Economy Empowerment Comedy Show.
Nice.
Right.
Nice.
Yes. On the lineup, I have Tenji, I have Sia Khatebe, I have Sfiso Nene, I've got Kidimoni Mlaozi, I've got Kanyisa Bunu, the award-winning Kanyisa Bunu. I've got a lot.
Why don't you have Nina Hasty on the lineup?
Yeah, I'll speak to her once she starts being funny.
Right, let's look at another video. Hi friends, it's the number one gossip diva once again, and you better tell somebody that your girl Jumaima's in the building. And this time around, the gross in monkeys. And Saturday being humble with my girl CTC Ojaiva Soweto. And I'm such a good dance floor, such engineers tall up dance floor, wafika into end the emnyama. Yang kwata la move at sister and kumbela vula vula na wena. It says Jamang Pega. Watch upuzan. Yo! Into a pumala, Ikunduani, into a nugala, and that's a conference call. A pick it up. Talk on a natty with a mapempas or with a macaque and just straight. Why, like, these people are Manukumlomo, they always insist on Ukulmanga Makama, Akipa Umoya Kulu, like Wani Kamalako, Wahamba Novani, Yamazu Hoshia, Savana. Fantastic. And I'm like, whoa.
Okay. It was a little bit funny. Just a little bit.
Well, it was funny also because it's true.
Yeah. Hey, dragon! Yeah. I love that.
You are fantastic.
Thank you very much, Kuli.
Okay, so where to after this?
After this, besides the smaller Nyana shows that I'm doing in the UK and Australia, I'll basically be local, filling up shows without Nina.
Okay.
And like, so sorry to throw shades, but you know, the previous show that I had, like the first show that I had was a sold out, double sold out. You know, I had to.
Double sold out.
So, yes, a PE comedy show.
Where was that?
It was double filled up.
That was.
Where was that?
That was 3 weeks ago at Carnival City, so that's why I'm bringing in. But you now featured. I'm saying this on live TV. You are featured.
Oh, just because we gave you a spot on the number one show on daytime TV.
Well, I've been on the operation. Never mind that, but yeah, I am.
Thanks.
Thank you very much.
I'm busy on that day.
Really nice seeing you.
I'm not 100% sure what just happened. but all I can tell you is thank you for being here.
Thank you for bringing
your friend. Thank you for loving me. And you can catch more of Tumi Stop Nonsense on YouTube. Don't forget, you can also catch our episodes on YouTube. This is Trending SA on SABC3.
Hey! Oh, it's okay. You can get out of character now. You can get out of character. I believe you.
Okay. This is my day. This is my day.
Ooh. I think your fan is tired.
Yeah. Or has turned into a man.
Who's my fan? What have you guys done?
Shaka's fan!
There she is. Put your hands where my eyes can see.
Your fans are load shedding.
Oh, look at that.
This is odd.
I've got more.
It went from... What is happening on the show today? Okay, listen. So
I feel you.
We're still in stitches and a bit confused about Tumi Stop Nonsense, but you can catch him alongside many other comedians at Carnival City 2 weeks from now. This is Trending SA, and we're going to kick off with a chat about the Rio Olympics. This should be trending everywhere.
Yeah. It should be trending everywhere. One of my favorite things to watch is the swimming.
Yes.
And that's because my daughter is a medal winning swimmer.
Really?
An Olympic medal winning swimmer.
Not yet. I mean, we're hoping so. I'm hoping to be like the Black Bert Leclos. And unfortunately.
Black Bert Leclos. It has a ring to it. It sounds like a band.
I'm the Black Bert Leclos.
Or you could just be Shaka Sisulu.
There's that.
Sisulu, one word. Anyway, Black Bert Leclos couldn't go. Because he's ill, but his son is still performing nonetheless.
Nice.
Big up to Chad Leclos. Anyway, I wanted to take a look at what we did the last time we went to the Olympics versus what we're doing now.
Cool. Okay.
So here's just a recap. In 2012, the South African Sports Confederation and Olympic Committee sent 125 athletes to compete across 17 different sports. They returned with... Six medals.
How many went? 17?
17 different sports. 125 people went.
That's ridiculous. What did they just realize it was Olympic Games like a month before?
Do you know that the American team has like over 500?
But that's exactly the point. And as well as the West Germans. Are they West Germans or they're just Germans?
They're West Germans.
The
worst ones are the better ones. Okay, so...
Germany, they have over 200 as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, what are you saying? So do the Americans bring home more medals?
They do bring home
more medals.
Do they? Yeah.
No, all I was saying is that I just think that we should be better prepared.
Don't think six medals is a lot? Because six medals, three gold, two silver, one bronze, is the best Olympic record
we should still have
that
more.
We've ever had.
Wow.
Since we rejoined the Olympic fold, which was in 92, the Barcelona Olympic Games.
Yes.
You guys were watching that?
I don't know those people who... 92, I was in second year varsity, now I was doing other things.
I was in standard one. Anyway, so I want to tell you about the 2012 Olympics. I was actually in London during that time. And Chad Leclerc was about to swim. And we were part of the cultural contingent. Myself, wow. Joey Razdin, Ronnie Modimo, Lakidibone Molaudzi. We were doing a show for the peoples during the Olympics. Mm. And then we had to get off stage quickly because Chad had to go and swim. And then he came home with a medal.
It was quite phenomenal. Yeah.
You know what's funny? Because you know when we were talking about this thing earlier in the green room, I was talking about, you know these people who always talk about, oh, the 2012 Olympics. Yeah, you know, I was there. Mm. And then I stayed at that thing. And then, oh, the 2010 Games. Oh, yeah, you remember? I had that experience.
You do get people like that.
You do get people like that.
I'm one of those people.
No, your story is cooler, though, because you were like...
I was part of the team.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. All right, okay. So here's what went down the last time, okay? We got a silver, Caster Semenya, 800 meters.
Yes.
Chad Leclos, the men's... 100 meter.
That's not Chad Leclos.
That is.
That's Chad Leclos.
Okay. They all look the same.
What about Chad Leclos?
Well, I mean, when the South Africans all look the same. And he got a 100 meter butterfly silver. He lost to Michael Phelps.
Michael Phelps, I'm retiring. Phelps, I'm not retiring.
The
ooh, giant I'm retiring.
Guy.
I'm
Did you
retiring.
See the Michael Phelps death stare on
Dude.
Twitter? It was ridiculous. It's just like Michael Phelps, like, death staring Chad Leclos, like, just before he goes on. That was very cool.
Well, he knows his enemy because you remember the last time in the 200-meter butterfly, Chad Leclos clapped him. Mm-hmm. This Michael Phelps guy.
Yeah, but then
the guy they all thought was unbeatable.
Mm. Mm. That's when he sucked and said, "Oh, I'm leaving."
Yeah, pretty much.
But then
yeah.
he came back. He did also beat Chad the other day. I'm sorry.
That's all right.
Whose team are you with?
I'm feeling for Chad.
I'm like heartbroken.
Do you know what? Listen, let me tell you a lesson I learned from politics. We don't discuss our losses.
Okay.
Let's move on.
Okay, can I say one more thing? My sister made the little pin that Chad is wearing on his tie.
Is this a true story? What's happening?
Low-key, we're very important. Anyway, I'm just like,
That's a cool story.
Yeah, it's a cool story. It's a very cool story. My sister made it. And it was made of silver.
Is it like your sister's sister or like a neighbor?
No. Like my we came out of the same...
Oh, okay, mother.
Mother.
Oh, thank you. I saved you.
Thank you.
Okay, so here's where we are right now. We have two silver medals, okay? Cameron van den Berg and, of course, Chad Leclos. And I want you guys to check this thing out.
So Cordis and van den Berg and Petey, they're the ones at the moment. Whoa. And Cody Miller in five.
And once he hits the water, Adam Petey just flies. The stroke rate is so fast. Finger-tipping the world record line at the moment. Let's see where he is at the 50-meter mark. He is below it by 8/100 of a second, 26.61. Good underwater. Van den Berg trying to go with him, though.
So Petey, who's already set a world record here, he's stunning. And look now, three quarters of a body length clear. 25 metres to go. He's got this race won already unless something extraordinary happens. And it won't because he is in a class of his own.
World record line appears as well. He's right there. Gold medal to the Great Britain team.
Since 1988, it is Britain now. It's Petey. And it's a world record. He can do more.
It's always so nice to see that flag.
It's such a nice feeling.
Let's see the next video. Let's see the next
video. Okay, there's another video.
All right, here's another video. This is the Chad Leclos video.
You know, I was out really hard. 23.3 is crazy at the 50. So, I mean, yeah, it was difficult. It was a difficult race, but I knew that the adrenaline would bring me home. I never die that bad in any race. So, yeah, it is what it is. It's an Olympic final, and, you know, it's always going to be hard.
No. So that wasn't the Chad Leclos video of him losing. It was him talking about how he lost.
Listen,
to a guy called Song Yang.
How he
Shaga,
won.
But he set a new world record for Africa and South Africa.
That is phenomenal. Yeah. See, you know what I love about sports people is the speeches that they always give. It's like the swimmers and racing drivers, they're like, you know, that's the thing is, you know, we did a lot of prep beforehand. And, you know, when you get out there in the rink or the swimming pond and you just got to hope for the best, eh? You just got to hope for the best.
Look at your face.
Yeah, lekker.
Toss.
Joburg, I'm coming home.
I'm coming home.
Oh, listen, we'll be watching a heck of a lot as the days go on. I believe we do have another video of Chad Leclerc. Should we play that? Okay, so here he is coming forth.
Coming forth? Why are we playing losing videos?
Didn't he win a gold just
now? We must be proud of him. Oh, look at that. Wow.
This is great propaganda.
Wow.
Oh, see how he's looking at Phelps. Well, this is what happens. Oh, this is when the one that he lost, the butterfly. Because he's so busy looking at Phelps.
No, this is because he immobilized him with his death stare.
No, but he wasn't. He literally wasn't staying
wait,
in his lane.
Flag.
He was not staying.
Guys, do you see this? I mean, this video even cuts off before the South African flag pops up.
That's because that's it, how didn't bad pop it was. Up. Because it was not a medical.
Only hit. 1, 2, and 3 pop up. 4. $4.
We don't care.
Okay, so look, we do have a couple of medals.
Mm.
We have a bronze as well. And we've got Castor Racing in a few days next week.
Yes.
Next week. So I'm expecting some medals there.
I'm going to be very angry if they start giving her hate again. I'm going to be very, very angry.
Of course they're going to give her hate because she's going to win gold. That's how it is.
Haters.
Win gold, get hated on.
But doesn't she have a trend of like not quite getting to that energy level at the crux?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's what I've heard. But I'm still supporting her. And I still want a selfie with her. You guys saw that. I could never have got a selfie. I want one. Bad.
You guys
Bad.
Do you think that Chad Leclerc would have performed better if his dad was there? Maybe it helped him focus? Because why is he staring in the other camp? Looking in the other... Stay in your lane, Chad.
Maybe he needed someone to focus him. No?
I think we're being a bit hard on
There's the also a lot to be said, guys. There's a hang of a lot of pressure on us, on a sports person. When you are on that level, the entire world is watching.
Of course.
We really need to celebrate the fact that this is the cream of the crop and there's split seconds between these people. So can we just... Chad Leclerc, we love you.
Yeah.
Chad Leclerc, we love you.
Team South Africa.
All 137 of you. Team SA Rise. In fact, teams are Rise.
Yeah. All right. So let's move on to our next hashtag. And it is Fat Side Stories.
Fat Side Story. I told you that was my hashtag. So earlier on, I gave you a short overview of the hashtag Fat Side Stories, which is a play on the title West Side Stories. I want to be in America. Yes, that's the song. This is how it started trending this week. 22-year-old Alexa Moreno, a gymnast from Mexico, was representing a country at Rio 2016 Olympics. This is someone who represented a country in a category that Mexico is really represented in. If you look at the 2012 games, there were only two Mexican gymnasts. I make one male and one female. Now, although she didn't do very well, she didn't qualify for the final rounds, she did do very well. She became number 31st. Well, she took 31st place.
Did you just say that she did very well by coming in?
31st in the world. 31st in the world. 31st in the world. I mean, there's a lot of people on this planet, right?
Listen, you know, but as couch potatoes, sitting and watching these people, 31st is amazing.
Exactly.
Okay?
Anyway, anyone saying let me that continue. It's amazing, deserves to get shamed.
But you know what?
Really, Shaga?
No, there's now you sound like these people.
So that's
exactly what happened with the Mexican, with this wonderful Mexican
girl. I'm lost shaming.
You would think that people would actually celebrate with her. They didn't celebrate with her. They just took the piss out of her and then they wound her up and they said she looked like a whale. People were criticizing her for her body shape, calling her fat. Why are we preoccupied with this weight issue and hell-bent on destroying people's lives? It's terrible. Of course, since then, the mean tweets have been removed by Twitter. Thank you very much, Twitter. But of course, there were some positive tweets as well, which we will read shortly. Oh. But someone else was also body shamed. It was an Ethiopian swimmer, Urobel Ubudwam. The Ethiopians themselves went on by, you look like a whale. What is wrong with people?
Wait, hang on. Ethiopian swimmer, fat Ethiopian, fat Ethiopian swimmer.
I know it sounds weird. Levels. But back to Alexa Moreno, guys.
He's not that big.
But back to Alexa Moreno. Just like Robel, I was happy to see the amount of support she got. The number of tweets supporting her outweighed the negative ones. This is some of They did. And Twitter took the hashtag to the next level when tubes started sharing their own fat side stories. Hashtag fat side stories. What I'd like to say to you guys is that we celebrate you no matter what size you are to encourage full
full-figured ladies and to reprimand body shamers. What we've got is that on the line, we've got a wonderful woman. Her name is Thick Leonce, and she's going to talk to her about her experiences as a larger lady and if she has been body shamed. Good morning. Good afternoon, actually.
Good morning, guys. How's everyone doing?
Hello, darling. In your interview with Destiny Magazine last year, you were quoted saying, when I was growing up, I never saw anyone who looked like me in a mainstream media. Whenever I would page through a magazine or switch on the TV, the black girls would always look skinny and light-skinned. And these people I couldn't relate to. So tell me how you saved yourself from losing your self-esteem, my Angel.
Firstly, I fell in love with taking pictures of myself. So I started taking self-portraits, and then I put them up on my bedroom wall.
Nice.
So every morning when I'd wake up, the first thing I would see is myself, and I would celebrate the girl that I saw in the pictures. And the last thing that I would see when I went to bed were pictures of myself. So that's how I gradually fell in love with myself.
That's powerful. That's really powerful.
Angel, what would you say to a big girl who's depressed, who's crying because there's some losers out there who are calling her fat and making her feel terrible?
Sorry, can you just say that again?
What would you say, Nana, to a vulnerable big girl who is being body shamed? What support would you give her?
I think first and foremost, like, chubby girls need to know that the world and the society in its own feels like if you're chubby, you do not deserve or you should not at all be happy or confident with the way that you look. So my biggest thing is that learn that your beauty is different from the next girl's beauty and learn to celebrate your own kind of beauty.
Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant.
Well, we see you're in demand, Lee.
Yeah.
And so we must celebrate this victory that you have over body shaming. Thank you very much, Thick Leonce. Amazing.
Amazing
woman.
Thank you, Angel. And keep on spreading the love to yourself and to other ladies, big or small.
Thank you so much.
Do you still have those pictures on your wall?
Of course I do. They just text ya.
Nah. Because you're beautiful inside and out.
I like beautiful. It. All right, after the break, we're going to be talking about Amantombazane and the release of Love, Light and Music 2, which will be out in a week from now. We'll be right back.
This is my This is my day.
Yeah.
Welcome back to Trending SA. All right, so earlier this week we saw Amantombazane all over the timeline. I had a look and it is all about Sex Bantwini, talented muso making strides all over. And, you know, it's interesting that the songs trend before we've even heard the songs or before they've been released, which is pretty legendary.
Be a first, though, right? A song trending before. Well, in fact, no, Kanye's also trended.
Before it was released.
No, because they're obviously a force, they're forces to be reckoned with.
But you see, the thing with this one is the single's only coming out on the 19th of August, right? But there's been a big call to entry for ladies, amantombazane, to send their selfies, and the winner gets to be featured as the album's cover artwork.
Really?
So but what does she win?
What did, no, the no, what album's does she
cover the artwork.
There's what? No car or...
But it's not what? Miss South Africa or Miss Zygmunt.
It's Miss album cover.
But my question is, what are the qualifications for the face?
You must be fly.
Okay, you know what?
Do we have some?
I think we have some.
Faces. Let's look at them.
I think Langla.
Oh, yes.
Yes, Miss Zygmunt.
You can, don't you dare. She's probably 12.
Miss Zygmunt.
I think the ladies must always remember it's a clean background. That's the most important.
Yes.
Clean background, please.
That's nice. She's got nice eyes. Almondy. What's happening?
She's lovely.
What is that, Shaga?
She's gorgeous. Oh!
But you know what, actually, that is the cover.
That is the cover.
Hey? That is the cover.
That should be the cover.
That should be the cover.
Because they love her. She looks so
good. Put Nandi on the cover and it's a winner.
Okay, so that, of course, is Nandi, who is married to Zygmunt Zwini. And they have a bundle of joy on the way. That is so beautiful. So make sure that if you want to be a part of hashtag amantombazane, send in your picture. But you know what?
I'm going
to
compete against that.
We have Nandi on the line. Oh! Hello, Nandi. Congratulations, baby.
Nandi.
Nandi, congratulations, Angel. I've been watching you the last couple of weeks trying to hide that belly, and it's been quite humorous.
Hey, yeah.
But to see
you. Congratulations to you.
Thank you. No, forget about us. And then to see you last night with the beautiful baby.
Thank you so much. No, I know a lot of people thought I ate too much. But no,
haters.
I can relate.
Well, your ankles were still small. We knew that it was not food. Nandi, are we calling him Shaga?
Please don't.
I'll say it's a good name, though.
That's a good name. I like that name.
Hang on. Have we got an exclusive here on our show? Was that a gender reveal, Nandi? Over to you.
Come on, Nandi.
Well, no. I was just saying it's a good name, but we love it. Yeah.
You're so professional.
Oh, you good.
How are you
Thank
feeling?
Thank you so much.
Champion too.
Nandi, how are you feeling? This is Coolie Roberts speaking, not Barbie.
Okay. Coolie, how are you?
I'm fabulous, Angel. How are you feeling? Oh. Are you not too ill, baby? You don't have, like, pregnancy niggles?
No, surprisingly not. No. But wait, first trimester was a mess. Can I tell you something really funny?
Yes, Nana.
At the BET Awards, if you look at the actual gown that we created, there's like a peplum, you know, vibe going on at the front. And I can't stand peplum.
I'm so glad that you said that. Sorry, Nandi, it's Nina speaking. I was like... everyone was going crazy about this dress, and I was like, peplum, and I was like, I love you so much, but peplum, though.
I was like, no, and we had to, because I just, my stomach already, I was already showing, and I was like, Emma, I hate peplum. But surprisingly, it worked in terms of covering the stuff, so that's the only reason I had a style. And then, in that heat, at some point, I was like, I think I'm going dizzy, because no one knew. So I'm interviewing Richie Maxwell halfway, and I'm just like, no, this can't be happening right now.
Well, you owned it. You owned it, and nobody knew.
Thank you.
At least you have an excuse, because peplum is unforgivable.
Absolutely. Especially now. You know that. I know. Absolutely. But I'm glad we can relate to that.
I love it. But you look gorgeous, and you are pulling it off, and you look amazing, and I wish you all the best for the rest of the pregnancy.
Thank you so much, guys, and congrats on the show.
Thanks. Thank you so much. Thank you.
But it's about you right now.
You are loved. And what a combo.
And congrats to your husband.
Got to Thank you very much. On his... keep supporting Color.
Keep the what? Fortune Color.
That's her.
Oh. Yes.
I want to ask you before we let you go, Nandi. Amantombazane trended before the song came out. I'm sure you have heard the song, the album. You know what's going on music-wise.
Yes.
What do you think?
Yes. In fact, I must be honest. I'm behind the fact it's released in a way because that's my favorite song, which is funny because it's about Amantombazane. But there's a twist to the song later on. Don't worry. But I love that song. I'm obsessed. And I'm just so proud of Dave because he's back, man. I mean, he's a legend when it comes to performing. I know I sound biased, but he really is amazing at what he does. So I'm excited.
That's beautiful.
And school fees for the kids. Guys, like, yay.
School fees for the kids.
I know. Well, listen, you're a darling. Look after yourself, and we will see you very soon.
Oh, love you guys, too. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you,
I hope
you,
the baby looks like you.
Coolie. Guys, bye to the best team. Cheers, guys.
Bye.
Guys, I need to ask this.
Yeah.
What on earth is peplum?
Okay.
Peplum.
So actually her dress was so phenomenal. It trended. The New York Times actually picked it up. It was unbelievable. People were like, Nandi Ngoma in this beautiful dress. So peplum is when you wear a dress and then there's this little bit that goes out in the middle.
That flares out.
Yeah, like
in
those
the,
old
exactly,
Victorian age
exactly.
dresses.
So it's 2016.
Like there's something underneath it.
Yes, it's 2016. Can we just not wear peplum?
I love peplum.
Why?
Thanks.
What's wrong with peplum?
Because it's gross. It's like you might as well wear a curtain. Like this, right? It's just gross.
Okay, she hates peplum. I hate peplum.
All right, so speaking of Fashion Week, fashion is a multi-billion-dollar industry. And every season we get invited to various fashion shows. I'm sure you do as well. So Fashion Week trends easily all over the world. We celebrate designers who showcase at these highly esteemed events. And everyone wants to sit front row. There's been controversy about who gets to sit front row sometimes. But what about the business side of it? How does it all work? So the clothes that get showcased aren't often the clothes that will be hanging on the rack, right? So how does it all work? Our first SA Fashion Week was 19 years ago, founded by director Lucilla Boysen.
My queen!
Who recognized the need for a platform to showcase South African designers' talent and to help them build their business and build their fashion brands. Then Dr. Precious Moloi-Motsepe has been running the current Joburg one for a couple of years now. A few years. So I want us to break down the business model of it. How do the fashion shows actually benefit designers? How does all of that work? So
the business of fashion, that's
what she
says.
We're speaking to, I mean, how would we describe David Tlale?
No need for introduction.
You know, so forward thinking and so talented, of course, it goes without saying. Hello, Mr. Tlale. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me. How are you doing?
Very well, thank
you. Intimidating us. Hello, Bololos.
So, on Wednesday, you showcased 9 upcoming designers in the Intern by David Tlale show at AFI. Tell us about the thinking behind that experience and how the show actually went.
So, the thinking behind the show is we have to give the young designers opportunity to showcase their talent and creativity in a national platform like Mercedes-Benz African Fashion International Fashion Week. So it's very important that they get to understand how to work with the show producer, the hair and makeup team, how the model casting works, how, you know, the whole logistics actually work, so that they get ready for their own brands when they graduate from this internship program, but also to also give them opportunity to meet the media, the people who make them or break them, and also potential buyers. And also just to know that fashion is not only about runway. There is actually business beyond the runway.
So what is the link between what happens on the runway and what will, for example, be on racks?
Well, it varies from designer to designer. When you look at the couture shows in Paris or in London or in New York or in Milan, you you see couture is like once off, never to be repeated. I used to fall into the trap to say I'm a couture designer until I understood what real couture is. It means it's only going to be done once, expensive fabrics. That's why you have a particular community that wears couture. And these women, they travel all over the world to follow the couture shows because they want to be the only one that has that garment. And it costs a lot of money.
Must be nice.
they've got the money, so they can afford to do it. So couture is purely like a prelude of what the trends will be for the particular season. And then we have the ready-to-wear shows, we showcase you know, creativity and the signature that we're going for, and colors and silhouettes for the particular season. Like right now at Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week Joburg, we're showcasing spring summer. So what you see on the runway, most of the collections that we do as a brand, David Lally, is what you'll be able to find on the racks. Yes, there are those show pieces.
Yes.
Because, listen, everybody can make a jacket. Everybody can make a shirt. Mm. Everybody can make a skirt. But you've got to excite people. Mm. You've got to bring down the creativity. You've got to bring down the razzmatazz and to say this is how we express ourselves as a brand. And people need to understand that Fashion Week is purely a marketing tool. And where after the shows, we will wash down the razzmatazz and give you the core product. So in the shows, you'll see the textures, the colors, the fabrications, and also the silhouettes. But then beyond that, when we get into retail space, that's when we give you the ready-to-wear pieces.
I think that was clear enough.
That's stunning.
Excellently articulated. Stunning. Thank you very much, David Lale, fashion maestro. That's what we've decided to call you. You're okay with that?
I don't know what to say.
I love it.
Well, thank you very much. We've got to take a quick break.
So much.
We'll be right back.
So much to say.
Yeah.
Is he still on the
line? This is my day. This is my day.
Come on, I'm here for my people. Oh, yeah. I love you too.
Really?
You're loyal. I appreciate you.
Fan love. And this is what happened. Welcome back. This is Trending SA. So many hashtags we couldn't get through because time just doesn't allow it. There's so many things we wanted to talk about with David Lale as well, because I think he needs to come here and we need to have a whole segment.
He needs to sit right here. You know, the one thing I wanted to find out, because the last show I saw he did at the Market Theatre, it was a specialty show. And he had the same thing, all of his interns producing their clothes, black, green, and gold. And I just wanted to find out where I can buy them, David.
The interns or the clothes? Very valid question. Okay.
What do you want to do with the interns?
I think we need to keep it moving. Just the clothes.
Hey,
just
listen, clothes. So I got an Instagram comment yesterday, in fact, and it said, thank you for the lovely show. I am watching in Zimbabwe.
Nice. They've got TV there?
Ah, I think it's Eval Godi watching in Zimbabwe. So thank you very much to everybody watching us all over.
In fact, Panache tweets us every day.
Every day.
Yeah. We see you. Fan love.
It's Nolwizi Sibanda from Zimbabwe.
I've never been to Zim, so feel free to invite.
What have we taken out of this week, Shaka?
Coolie wants free invites.
Coolie?
That I can get free invitation to Zimbabwe if I smile.
I don't know. I just love you guys so much.
Yay. It's been a big week.
It's been fantastic. Once again, I will repeat, I like the fact that we are giving our shining stars a platform.
Yes.
Yeah, I like that.
Yes.
So I like that.
Were you guys actually friends with Auntie Mama? I mean, are you friends?
No. The rest of the people I'm very good friends with, but not this one.
Because that was slightly different kind of banter.
We are fellow comedians, although... That's a strong
Your
word.
Industry friends. Whoa.
That's a strong
We will see
word.
You on Monday.
That's a strong
Midday.
Word.
That's a strong word. SABC 3 Trending SA. Bye-bye.
It's been a great week. Thank you, guys.
This is my